Are you an electric skateboarder who wants to take your e-skating game to the next level? Then you're on the right channel. In this video series, we'll be taking a look at some ways for you to step up your e-skate game and keep your ride in tip-top condition. In this episode, we'll talk about board maintenance, how to take care of your board so it will take care of you. Let's get started. Wait, these aren't my hands. What'd you do with my hands? Oh well, I guess these will work. Let's get started. So the first thing we're going to discuss is standard skateboard maintenance. The standard stuff that you would do on a regular skateboard applies to electric skateboards as well. Let's start with the wheels. I said wheels! Okay, so for wheels on your board, you want to make sure that the bearings are in good shape. If there's any sandiness or grinding in the bearings, swap them out. You don't want to leave them unattended because your wheels may fall off if your bearings burst. To swap your bearings out easily, stick your wheel on your truck axle one bearing at a time and pry with a bit of force. Next, you want to make sure you have the correct type of nut on your truck axle. Make sure you're using a nylock nut instead of a regular nut. Notice how the nylock nut has a rubberish ring on the inside threads. This prevents your nuts from unscrewing off the wheel while you're riding. And when you're tightening the nut onto the axle, do not tighten it down hard. Tighten until the wheel can't move side to side, and then untighten the nut just a smidge. This will ensure your wheels have minimal rolling resistance. Ensure that all other screws on your board are tightened and thread locked wherever necessary. Also, you can increase the top speed of your board by up to 5 miles per hour by hitting the like button on this video. Your wheel's lifespan can vary a lot. If you see cracks in the urethane, that's okay, you can still use it. However, if you start seeing chunks come out of the wheel, it may be time to consider a replacement. For electric skateboards specifically, just like a car, it's a good idea to rotate the front and back wheels if you have a belt drive. This will help your wheels wear evenly. Next, let's talk about trucks, more specifically, your bushings. To keep your bushings in top condition, make sure you're not over-tightening your bushings. Basically, when you tighten your bushings, you're compressing them. If you compress them too much, the sides will deform and bend outwards. When this happens, the performance of your bushings become a lot worse. And keeping your bushings this way for too long will wear them down way faster. Always make sure the sides of your bushings aren't bent outwards, unless they were designed that way. If you feel you need to tighten your bushings even more, don't be afraid to experiment and swap to harder bushings, or use different hardware. If your trucks start to squeak when you turn, that's not necessarily a bad thing, but if you don't want it to squeak, a quick fix solution is to get a bar of soap and shave bits of the soap into the pivot cups. This should stop the squeaking for a while. However, if you notice your pivot cup tearing or cracking, it's time to replace it. To do that, take a flathead screwdriver and jam the head into your pivot cup. Then, lever the old pivot cup out of the pivot hole and replace it with any new pivot cup that's marked specifically for your trucks. There's a whole wide world of bushings and pivot cups out there just waiting for you to explore. All you have to do is not be afraid to spend some money. Now let's talk about the electronics portion of the electric skateboard. All electric skateboards have batteries. They're a bit temperamental, so it's a good idea to try and satisfy them. The more you recharge your board, the less capacity your battery can maintain. This happens with any battery, but there are ways of slowing down this effect. If you know you're not going to be discharging the battery significantly within a few weeks, it's a good idea to leave your battery around half charged. This helps preserve the lifespan of your battery. If you have many boards and you know you won't ride some of them for a while, a timer plug is a cheap and inexpensive accessory you can use to charge your boards to around half after a ride so you can store them. Also, try not to completely discharge your battery all the time. Discharging your battery completely, such as by riding your board until it's dead, also reduces the capacity your battery pack can hold. Try not to store your boards in damp places. If you live in a humid area, check for rust on places like metal electronics enclosures, motors, and mounting screws. If you run your board through water, be sure to wipe it down after the ride. If you live in a dusty area, periodically check your motors for metal particles and remove them. Hopefully this video has been helpful to you. If you have any more suggestions for board maintenance, leave a comment below. If you liked the video, give it a like. Thanks to Sophia from Bay Area eSkate for helping out with the script. Check out her eSkate reviews in the link in the description. See you in the next video!